Hello everybody, welcome back. Today I thought it would be fun to come and make this pop-up stepper card kit that I got in my goodie bag from Hunky Dory recently. When I was doing the video and showing you what was in both my bags, I actually received two kits. I got this one here that we're going to do today, and I got this one here, which I have already made up. As you can see, it's very beautiful, very dimensional, absolutely fantastic. But I did say in that video that I'd come back and make one altogether. So that's what we're going to do today. If you missed the goodie bag video, I'll leave it linked in the description box. I believe the goodie bags are completely gone now, but it gives you an idea of what's in them for if they do them again in the future. If you like this kind of video, please do make sure you're subscribed to my channel. And if you enjoyed today's video, please give it a big thumbs up. So before we get too into it, I do want to talk about this kit really, really quickly. So they do fold flat. So you can see it's got a card and it folds down flat, and it does go in an envelope to post. And then when the person receives it, they can just take it out the envelope, pull it all down and go, oh, what a beautiful card. Which I think is great. Now in this kit you do get everything you need to make the card, and you get the envelope as well, which I think is pretty good. There's also instructions on the back of this piece here telling you step by step how to do it. So I think this piece of kit is fantastic because it can appeal to so many people. If you are brand new to card making and you haven't got a clue what you're doing, start with this. Honestly, you'll be able to make a beautiful card. You don't really need anything special to do it. It comes with everything you need apart from a few foam pads and some adhesive. Everything else is in here. And if you're an experienced card maker, then this is great for just at the end of the day, if you want to unwind and you've been really busy all day and you don't want to think too much, you can just sit down and do this in front of the telly. So I think this does appeal to a wide cross-section of people. Maybe if you want to try a fun fold but you're too scared, or you don't have a scoreboard, this is the way to go. So this one is the, I don't know if it's got a name, pop-up stepper card beautiful bicycle. There you go, pop-up 506. I think these are probably still on the website, so I will link a Hunky Dory in the description box. It's not an affiliate link, it's just to be helpful that you'll be able to go and hopefully find this over on the website. I think they've been launching recently some like Christmas style ones of these, which would be fun. Okay, so as you can see, this is how it is when you get it out of the packet. There is the envelope. So it does come with its envelope. We'll put that off to one side. And it is very, very easy. You've just got to pop the elements out. Everything is labelled A and B. Very easy to do. And then on the back, as you can see, there are step-by-step instructions on how to do this. So I think at times I'll probably speed it up just because you don't really want to watch me put pads on things and pull release papers off. But we'll do this together as best we can. So the first thing I'm going to do is poke this out. So this is the first piece we need. Okay, if you want to go that extra little step and just make your card look polished, see these little notches, I don't know if you can see, where it's come out of the backing. Just really carefully grab your scissors and just cut those notches. Careful not to cut into the cardstock. But just trim the notches down. It just helps give a slightly more polished look to your card. Having said that, is anyone really going to notice the notches? Probably not. But you know you've done it. So there we go. So that is the first thing I'm going to do. So this piece is going to become our card. So this line here, you see it's all scored for you. I'm gonna fold that away from us, grab a bone folder and just burnish that line. And then this one here, you can see, we are going to fold that one towards us. And then this one here, we're going to fold away from us, and that becomes a mountain. So that's kind of how it looks for right now. So next, what we're going to do is we're going to tape this bit under there so that it looks like that. I'm going to grab some tape and do that really quickly. So I've tried to tidy as I go. So this is where we're at right now. We've got the card base, it's stuck down on the bottom. We're going to put this to one side. And then what I'm going to do now is bring back this piece here. And I am going to actually remove everything from this sheet now. So that's everything removed from the sheet, and the reason I've done this is because personally I find it easier to add the decoupage before I put anything else on the card, so before I put these on. Plus, by having it all laid out, I can kind of see where it all goes easier. I found with the other one I had, there were bits dotted around everywhere. And I was trying to add decoupage once it was all put together when I realised I'd missed bits. So this is just easier for me, but you do you, however you find it easier. So now we're going to start building the decoupage up. So I'm going to just lay it out first. Make sure I get it all in the right places before I stick anything down. Make sure I'm happy. And then once I'm fairly happy with the fact that I've got it all where it's supposed to go, then I'll start adding the foam pads. So I'm fairly happy with that. There's nothing to say you have to use every single piece of decoupage you get with the kit. It's your personal preference. You make it how you want to make it. So, for instance, this butterfly here, I'm actually going to be putting on the trellis. And with these ones, I don't really see that there's any set rules with having to put certain flowers on certain flowers. They all look fairly similar as long as you're happy. That's the main thing. So I'm going to speed it up whilst I placed foam pads on these. And I'm going to start sticking them to each individual element. So even though that was on high speed, hopefully you saw that it didn't take too long to decoupage all of these. So now what we're going to do is do some more folding and start putting the card together. So we're going to start with the one that says A on the bottom, and we are going to fold along that scored line. We're going to fold it away from us, and we are going to burnish that. I'm just going to pop, you see there's a bit there that's not popped out quite right. So I'm going to pop those bits out as well. Get rid of those. Okay, so that's where we are. Now these bits, you can see, also have a scored line. So we're going to fold that away from us as well. And we're going to burnish those lines. Okay. Okay, and we're going to do the same with part B. So that bottom one, we're going to fold away from us. And very carefully, going to burnish that. And then these bits here have the score lines. These actually have two, if you can see there. So we're going to fold both of those away from us. Just like that. Burnish those. Okay. So starting with part A, we need to put tape here, and we also need to put tape on the ends of these tabs. So let's just do that really quickly. In fact, these ones also have extra score lines that we just need to fold down. There we go. So we're just going to put tape on the end piece. So the first thing we're going to do now, we're going to remove the release paper from the tape. Or if you've used glue, you could use glue, whatever your preference is. I'm just going to grab that up, and we're going to match this up with the A on the bottom of the card base, with the picture facing you. Just push that down really well. Then we're going to take the release papers off of here. Just like that. This time we are going to fold this all the way down like that, and we're going to raise the base up. So here's the base. We're going to raise this up with these lowered so that it catches, so that it all folds flat for postage. Give it a push. Then when you bring the base down carefully, it's standing out. We're going to do exactly that with this one, with B. B is going to attach to the bicycle. So we're going to grab some tape. We're going to run it along the bottom where the B is. Never use my good scissors for cutting tape. I always use really old crusty scissors for that. Then again, miss out the long piece. You just want to put the tape on the short end. Okay, so again, we're going to remove this release paper. Picture side facing you, line it up carefully on the base. And give it a good press. And we're going to remove this release paper here on the little tab. And this side. Okay, so hold those down flat like so. Bring the whole base up. Give it a good press. And now when we bring it down, ta-da! And that is the card done. the beauty of it is when this comes out the envelope, because we glued the bottom bit with the little picture underneath at the very beginning, it still looks like a scene when it comes out the envelope. And then they just pull it down and there is the card. Then all you've got to do is write your message inside, and on the back it says handmade for you. Isn't that lovely? And that is how simple it is to make these pop-up stepper card kits from Hunky Dory. That took me no longer than, well, it's saying 28 minutes on my camera, but obviously there was a bit of waffle before I even started. So I reckon about 20 minutes, 25 minutes, something like that, to make a really beautiful card. I think these are great. I think these are so pretty. I love that they fold flat. I love that they've even thought of, when it comes out the envelope, finishing off the picture down here, even though when it's up like this, you don't see it. It's the little things that make me happy, and that makes me really happy. But as I said, you don't need to be a really experienced card maker to make these. You don't need to think too much about what you're doing. I love them. I think they're great and they make lovely cards. They fit in a 5x5 envelope. Yeah. So it's 5x5 envelope. Depending how big your foam pads are, obviously may impact the postage costs a little bit. But yeah, they're not massive to post, so that's a great thing. So please do let me know what you think in the comments below. Let me know if you found this video useful, and if you're not already subscribed to my channel, please, please do hit the big red subscribe button. If you've enjoyed the video, please leave it a thumbs up, and thank you so, so much for coming to watch. I really appreciate everyone that takes time out of their day to come and watch my videos, so thank you so, so much. I will be back soon with more videos, so until next time, take really good care, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.